While Silent Hill 2 Remake is a great game, its technical state at launch was far from perfect, with frequent reversal stuttering and performance issues. And yesterday, the game received its first post-launch update, 1.04, which according to the patch notes, brings not only several gameplay improvements, but also key technical updates. These include support for the latest DLSS and FSR with frame generation, as well as a new setting and various fixes aimed at reducing stuttering. So in this quick video, we'll focus on the technical side of this patch by examining the frame generation implementations and the new setting to see if there are any improvements and most importantly if Bluebird team has successfully managed to mitigate the stuttering issue. So let's begin with DLSS and FSR with frame generation. The patch notes mentioned reduced visual glitches when using DLSS. Now DLSS at launch exhibited motion trails behind leaves and certain particles, and personally I did not notice this issue much as it only happens when the camera is still. And if I move the camera, as you can see here, that issue disappears. And to fix this problem, this new patch simply updates DLSS DLL from 3.5.10 to 3.7, which completely eliminates this visual issue. Regarding frame generation, the game now supports DLSS frame generation, and I briefly tested it on the 4070 Super and it works as intended. Though the performance boost is only around 50 to 55%, which falls short of the typical 70 to 80% increase we get on most other games. FSR 3 also has its own frame generation, but unfortunately it only works with FSR upscaling and it does not support DLSS, XeSS or even FSR 1 on TSR, and it's one of the worst implementations of FSR frame generation as enabling it leads to frequent pauses and crashes. So I currently don't recommend using it. If you need frame generation and you don't have an RTX 40 series GPU, I suggest using Nukem's mod by downloading the universal version and copy the files from the version folder to this location. And if you don't have an RTX 20 or 30 series GPU, use the DLSS enabler instead. And as you can see here, Nukem's mod unlocks DLSS frame generation on the 3060 Ti, and it works much better than the official FSR frame generation implementation. Let's move on to this new setting called Scene Occlusion. This setting basically changes how the engine handles occlusion calling, which is an optimization method that every game uses to improve performance by avoiding the rendering of objects that are completely hidden or occluded behind other geometry. And prior to this patch, the game relied on occlusion queries. But now we have two additional options, disabled and HZB or hierarchical Z buffer. And after testing all three options, at least here in Silent Hill Town, I did not see any significant improvements when it comes to traversal stuttering. And visually, since this setting only affects hidden objects and geometry, it's really hard to notice any visual difference between the options. Performance-wise, when GPU bound in this area, HZB provides a slight 2% gain compared to disabled and occlusion queries. However, if we try to make the game CPU bound by using DLSS Ultra performance, the situation changes in favor of occlusion queries and disabled, with around 27% performance gain when going from HZB to disabled and 30% when going to occlusion queries. So in this case, there is no definitive recommendation because the best option depends on the CPU and GPU. If you are GPU bound, HZB seems like the better option due to its small performance boosts. And if you are CPU bound, either disabling scene occlusion or using occlusion queries should offer better performance. And it would be helpful if you could share your specs in the comments down below and let us know which option gives you the best results. Finally, let's examine the stuttering and see if this new patch has made any improvements. Here in the forest, we can see that the new patch does not exhibit the consecutive stuttering that the launch version suffers from in this particular area. And this improvement has nothing to do with scene occlusion. occlusion, because if we test all three options, we can see that none of them show any stuttering here. And I think this improvement is caused by the sky map generation fix that the patch notes mentioned. As for general performance, there is no significant difference between the launch version and this new patch, just some minor 2% improvement, which falls within the margin of error. And in Silent Hill Town, the stuttering is still here and it occurs in the exact same spots. And it is as frequent and consecutive as in the previous version. And again, the performance is pretty much similar between the two versions. To be honest, I did not expect the stuttering to be fully resolved, and I don't think it will be completely eliminated. This is a core issue with Unreal Engine, and it seems like Epic is not prioritizing fixing it. The stuttering problem has been around since Unreal Engine 4, and Epic only cares about the visual aspects of the engine with techniques like Nanite, Lumen, and recently Megalights. But the question is, what is the point of all these advanced and cutting-edge techniques if the users are distracted by constant stuttering and itching, regardless of how powerful their system is? So I really hope Epic takes this issue more seriously and that we see some improvements to the CPU multi-threading performance and asset streaming in future iterations of Unreal Engine 5 to help mitigate this reversal stuttering issue. And with that, we arrive at the end. Thank you so much for watching and for your time. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, and if not, leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for future videos, and hopefully I'll see you all in the next one.